Hey everybody, Doug Reynolds here, your Sacramento area realtor. We're living in a really weird, wild, fascinating time right now. I've been watching the real estate market. We're a month into kind of the coronavirus shutdown, and I've been watching the stats every day, the data, trying to see what's going on, what's happening and everything. So this is the monthly update for April. I always do this every single month, and we look at the stats at the previous month that just came out. So we're gonna talk about the March stats. And then at the end, I'll talk a little bit about coronavirus and the market that's going on right now. So these stats that we're gonna go over, they're having a small impact on with the coronavirus impacting these numbers, because March data is impacted by what was happening in January and February and a little bit at the beginning of March. So let's throw the stats up here. All right, as you can see, active listing inventory 1658, that's the number of active homes available on the market right now. That is up from last month about 16%, but it's actually down from this time last year about 12%. So more on the market now than we had in February, but less than we had at this time last year, okay? Pending sales, these are the number of properties that are basically in escrow right now. That's almost about 1,500. That's down a little bit from February, about 10% down, but it's up almost 12% from this time last year. So the down, the month over month, that is showing a reflection of the coronavirus having an effect there, because we did have a lot of deals fall out of escrow when everything kind of happened on that big famous day there in March. And then additionally, not as many are getting into escrow since then, since the 4 weeks we've had since then. So that's showing up in the numbers there, where our pendings are down a little bit than we would expect at this time this year, okay? And then total number of closed escrows, 1170. That's up just a little bit from February, and then it's down from this time last year. So same thing, a slight impact there. There were a number of transactions that basically either fell out of escrow, so they didn't close, or there were some that maybe would have closed in March, but because of delays and things that are going on in the industry, they're maybe gonna get pushed to April and not be closed in March there. So a little bit of an impact there, but not majorly. Months worth of inventory still hovering at 1.4 months of inventory. It's still pretty low. That's been the same across the board for over a year now. Months worth of inventory is, if no new homes came on the market today at the rate that we're selling homes, how quickly would we run out of properties? So that's a low marker there. Kind of a average number is about 2.5 months would be kind of a balanced market. So statistically showing it's sort of favoring sellers, but in actuality, I don't think that's quite the case in the market. The median actually did tick up to 400,000 there. So our median for Sacramento area is at 400,000, up a little bit from month over month, and then up almost 10% from this time last year. So those numbers, yeah, you can look at them and everything, but it's not really telling us what's happening today or what's going to be happening moving forward, because those stats are kind of coming from looking back in time. So right now, it's a really interesting market. There's basically a number of people that have taken their house off the market, sellers, they're just like, hey, not doing anything here, gonna wait this out. There's a number of buyers that have done the same thing as well. But then there's also a pretty good majority of people that are either their vacant houses that need to be selling, that are on the market, or they're sellers for just whatever various reasons they're needing to sell and they're putting their house on the market right now. Additionally, there are buyers. I've got 3 deals in escrow right now with buyers that got into escrow after the whole coronavirus stuff started, okay? So there are buyers that are moving forward, they're pushing forward, they're saying, hey, I've got a solid job, I'm comfortable with this. Obviously, I'm gonna be wise, we're gonna do social distancing, we're gonna wear gloves and a mask and things like that, but they're moving forward. So there's not as much going on as we would expect at this time of year, just the sheer volume. There's not as many houses as we would expect, there's not as many escrows going on right now, there's not as many closings as we would expect, but that's all basically because of the coronavirus stuff. However, things are still moving forward. Yes, there's some stumbling blocks. Lenders are figuring things out, escrows figuring things out, realtors are trying to figure things out and everything, but really people are working together as collective, as a whole, to try to keep things together and be moving forward for those people that do want to buy right now. Interest rates are incredibly low right now, and so there's buyers that are wanting to move forward. I've got some active buyers at the moment right now as well too. And so it's an opportunity. There's not quite as much competition right now as there has been in the last several months in the market. And so some buyers are seeing that as, hey, interest rates are crazy low and I don't have as much competition going on right now. I'm gonna get out there. With that being said, there's still about 40% of the properties that are going into escrow right now have multiple offers on them. So there's still some buyer competition going on. It's just not as crazy as we would have expected. So hope this video was helpful. Check me out at realestatewithdoug.com. You can reach out to me if you got any questions. Check out my YouTube channel. I've done a ton of videos on real estate and coronavirus and what's going on. It can give you some good insight and information there. I hope you are staying safe and making sure you're working on your own physical health as well as your mental health during this time. And I look forward to connecting with you soon, and clear skies.